Now it's time for me to do a second video of the condition of the trees outside my window in Hallifax, which is really pitiful, but this is everywhere in Hallifax. And it's now September, I believe, the 7th today. So we're still like a month away before the trees are supposed to start turning color. And I'll just do a scan around and show you. We'll start back with this one down here. And the colors on this tree are really terrible. And the leaves are in really poor condition, as you can see. And this is not from fall. And there's... there's a lot of these trees that have yellow leaves everywhere, just colored leaves. There's the next tree over to it. So something really bad is happening. Trees are all dying. And like usual, the sheeple are too stupid to pay attention to anything. They walk around, they look at all the sick trees everywhere, and nobody talks about it. How did the people become so stupid not to notice that even their own environment is under attack? Look at all the leaves all over the ground. This is like summertime, and there's leaves falling everywhere. And it would look like that they're falling because it's fall, but it's not. Because if you look, a lot of these leaves are full of green. And leaves don't fall when they're off trees when they're green. In fall, they turn yellow and then they fall off. Like these here, that's not from fall though. Because the tree, most of the tree's green, and that's not how trees change. When the sap stops flowing because of cold weather, the whole tree changes color at the same time, and that's how it works. And this is not what's happening here. See the yellow spots everywhere in these trees? All this colored, all these colors are wrong. Like the greens aren't even green, they're like a black green, there's yellows. See, look at all the discolored leaves. And that's not from fall, because if it was in fall, there wouldn't be any green leaves. They would all be discolored evenly. No different colors in one tree. See, this tree never came back to life. This one now, you saw it last time, and now you can see it's like really finished. So the yellow leaves, this tree's really bad off. Look at all the colors on this tree. Look at the yellows on this tree. It's all burnt. Radiation or whatever is doing it. Chemtrails. Doesn't really matter. The world's gone insane. People don't care what you have it down about polluting the environment. But it's the real problem in this world is a corrupt corporate state. How everything works on a corporation is a crime syndicate. Corporations are structured as crime syndicates. This one's really hurting bad. There's a lot of these around Hallifax. I was going around yesterday and talking to people. And people are in denial, but they can't help but notice that there's trees that are diseased and sick everywhere. These leaves have been falling off that tree all summer long, like for the last 2 months. But everywhere you look, all the trees, the leaves, the edges of the leaves are all discolored. This has never happened before. This is not the way nature looks. Look at the poor colors of all these trees. But better yet, you know, I mean, I'm doing it on video, but go outside and go look at the trees for a change, guys. Go up to your neighborhood skyscraper or tall building and, you know, look down like I'm doing at all the trees in your town, in your city. I had one guy from the USA, when I posted this video on his blog, he sent me a link to a video that he did showing that where he lives, all the forests look like this. And this is somewhere far away on the other side of the US. And I've had a woman tell me in BC that they're having the same thing there, British Columbia. And so far, I'm getting reports that it's happening the same all over North America. Look at the condition of these trees. And people aren't concerned. All the trees are dying. Well, it's pretty pitiful, you know, that people aren't speaking up and aren't asking the government and everybody in the media to do a story. But our media, we don't have a media anymore. We have idiots living off the glory of all the money that the media has and all the fancy cameras. And doesn't matter how fancy the cameras are, we don't have a media anymore. It doesn't report any kind of truth whatsoever. It doesn't have a clue what truth is. It fabricates its own stories. It actually has actors acting out in front of the cameras doing interviews for whatever the story they're doing. I learned that when I was covering the Occupy movement and saw the media bringing in their own actors and faking everything. So, see, everywhere you look, now remember these trees, okay, they aren't green, okay, they're not. The colors are all off. This is not darker green. This is like everywhere you look. I doubt very much that next spring there's going to be any of these trees that are going to still be showing leaves. All these trees have discolored. They're burnt with yellow, rust color. Everywhere you look. It's really far away and it's kind of hazy. It's early morning right now. I'm doing this before the sun comes out. Because the only way to get the contrast and be able to see the trees is to do it when there's no sun out, because the sun causes so much shadows on the trees that you can't see what you're looking at when it comes to the leaves. All the leaves cause shadows, and so if you want to do this in your neighborhood, make sure it's overcast. See? Everywhere you look. I can't do it way up there because it's too early in the morning and too much haze. And you can see I've got quite the view from where I live, and this is why I noticed this back in June. I said something's really wrong, all the trees are sick. So I may be the only one that's ever done a high view like this over a city with a camera to show people what's happening. Remember, guys, this is not fall colors. This is not natural at all. It will be fall colors in another month or so, maybe a little longer than that. It takes a good cold night before the sap stops flowing in trees and the trees start going dormant for the winter. Depends which part of the world you live in, but here in Canada, we in Nova Scotia, as you know, trees turn color and we lose them in the spring. They come back in the spring. So, are you seeing enough dead trees everywhere yet? You know, can you believe that that people actually are destroying this planet? They'll do anything for greed. Their corporate image, their fake image, you know, they act out their lives. They're going to hit the fancy car and the fancy house. Anything for self-gratification and the destruction of the environment and everything that's natural and beautiful, whether it be natural human nature or everything else, they don't care. The world is so sick today. Anyway, I just wanted to do a quick one because I'm getting tired of doing this. Oh, wait a second. We'll go on this side. We'll just give you a little bit more here. look healthy until you go up close and look at them. Same when you walk around, you can go up close and look at the trees. See? Well, they all look like they're burnt from radiation or something like that. But go have a look at the branches or look at my pictures and look at the link below this video. And you'll see close-ups of all these, what these leaves look like. See? It's like that everywhere. Everything's dying. Yep. Some people are depopulating the world. They think there's too many people. Possibly there's too many destructive people. But I myself say the real problem is when they introduced corporatism to the world. The greedy bastards that loved making money at the expense of the environment and everybody else. And the military-industrial complex that's chemtrailing the skies and geoengineering to control the weather and environmental warfare. The list of insanity doesn't end, and that's the problem. The reason why all this insanity is happening in the world is because people refuse to believe that anything like that could be happening. And they don't go and check to see if it is happening. And because they think, well, no way can people be that crazy, be doing all that stuff. So nobody checks it out for themselves. And as long as you don't check out things for yourself, and you don't speak up like I'm doing here, then the insane are going to keep doing more and more insane things until they just finally just completely destroy things. And you'll wonder why one day, why is the earth dying? Why are the trees dying? It's because you never spoke up. You've got just as much power in this world as anyone else just by speaking up. You know, tell your neighbors, man, we don't want chemtrails in our skies, but do you speak up? No. You don't think chemtrails are real.